State Citizen versus U.S. Citizen, 3, continued. There have always been two classes of citizens in America. The Constitution for the United States of America talks about two classes of citizens. Article 4, Section 2, Clause 1 says, "The Republic citizens of each state shall be entitled to all privileges and immunities of citizens in the several states." Emphasis added. The courts have talked about the two classes of citizens. There is in our political system a government of each of the republic, several states, and a government of the United States. Each is distinct from the other and its citizens of its own. That's U.S. versus Crankshank, CRUIKSHANK, 92 U.S. 542. Another United States Supreme Court case. The 14th Amendment creates, or at least recognizes, for the first time a citizenship of the United States as distinct from the citizenship of the Republic several states. Black's Law Dictionary, 5th edition, at page 591. One may be a citizen of a state and yet not a citizen of the United States. Thomason versus State, Corey versus Carter, McCarthy versus Froelkel, F-R-O-E-L-K-E, in Wentz, W-E-H-L-I-T-Z, 16 Wisconsin, 443, and McDowell, D-O-N-E-L, versus State. Before, both, and after the 14th Amendment to the Federal Constitution, it has not been necessary for a person to be a citizen of the United States in order to be a citizen of the state. That is Cross, C-R-O-S-S-E, versus Board of Supervisors, Baltimore, Maryland, 1966, citing U.S. Supreme Court slaughterhouse cases, and U.S. versus Cruikshank, Cruikshank, C-R-U-I-K-S-H-A-N-K, 92 U.S. 542, again in 1875. These modern cases, they cite the actual law. So therefore, the UCC and the actual law must apply to all court cases. There are two classes of citizens, citizens of the United States and of the state, and one may be a citizen of the former without being a citizen of the latter. That's Gardena versus Board of Registrars, 1909 in Alabama. Citizenship of the United States does not entitle citizens to privileges and immunities of the citizens of the state, since privileges of one are not the same as the other. The state citizen has a right to travel. The United States citizen cannot travel. They are tenants and residents and commercial property. That is Tashiro, that's T-A-S-H-I-R-O, versus Jordan, a California Supreme Court case. The United States Supreme Court quite thoroughly expanded on the two classes of citizenship in the case of, here we go again, folks, Maxwell versus Dowell, 20 SCR 448, where it said that there was a citizen of the United States and a citizen of the states, which were distinct from each other, depending upon different characteristics and circumstances in the individual, that it was only privileges and immunities of the citizens of the United States that were placed by the amendment under the protection of the federal constitution. and that the privileges and immunities of a citizen of a state, whatever they may be, were not intended to have any additional protection by the paragraph in question, but they must rest for their security and protection where they have heretofore rested. Maxwell versus Dowell. That means right to bear arms to protect your family from invasion. That means police officers also coming to your door. These two classes of citizenship continue to this day. Privileges and immunities clause of the 14th Amendment protects only those rights particular to being a citizen of the federal government, which are benefits, not rights, folks. You have to pay for the benefits. It does not, by income taxes. It does not protect those rights which relate to state citizens. 14, section 1, Jones versus Temer, T-E-M-M-E-R, 829 F Supplement, 1226, Colorado, 1993. Because there are two classes of citizens, and also because of circumstances that will become known below, it is necessary to assert your sovereignty, people, in order to understand how and why you assert your sovereignty. We need to have some background knowledge. A state citizen is one of we the people, found in the preamble to the Constitution contract of 1768, 87, and 89. You can be in a state without being in the United States. In fact, if you read their codes, the United States in the United States code is the District of Columbia and its territory. The Puerto Rico website even talks about it. What is a United States citizen? A U.S. corporate citizen is a government slave to whatever you are a citizen of, and you have no rights. A state of citizen is also a fictitious entity, legal fiction, corporation, government slave, and has no rights. A citizen of a republic, 50 several states, has all rights, freedoms, but lacking common law justice, but you don't know it and are not knowledgeable enough or are too weak-minded to enforce your rights and freedom and are not educated in your history. A Texian American of the Texas Republic Nation has all rights, freedom, and common law justice, and you know this. And live it every day without any government telling you what to do or taxing you or your property, as long as you are sworn in as a Texian with a loyalty oath, are law-abiding, and do not harm or injury or do no harm or injury to your fellow Texians. The good news, folks, is that the sovereign Texas Republic Nation has TRN crypto coins that they're similar to bitcoins that are backed by gold and silver and other precious metals and minerals. Okay, they can be traded, they can be bought, they can be sold, they can be anything that the crypto coin can, that the bitcoin can, and are accepted by merchants. Okay, we have nearly 1 million square miles of land area reaching from the state of Texas and state to all the way to the state of California's Pacific Ocean shoreline to the west in the Texas Republic Nation. You can get out of your corporate prison by going to cancelonemortgage.info, which is the website above, to pay off your presumed debts and read about our bank-verified and bank-approved process, pre-processed LPN negotiable security that legally by UCC law, federal law, United States law, banking law, American common law, and international common law is money, legal tender, and U.S. currency, and as such may be used to pay off your debts and save you thousands of dollars. You shouldn't be concerned about the fee, folks. It's the money, the thousands of dollars you save, that shouldn't matter. Just order our 1995 LPN e-booklet for informational and educational purposes at cancel1mortgage.info and decide for yourself. This e-booklet has the loans, it has bank-approved promissory notes copies, it has proof of payoff, it's actually paid off debt, and it has the 7 items we need to do the processing. Remember, our LPN security process is not a do-it-yourself process. We do not have step-by-step instructions on how to process an LPN security or promissory note, and we do not give you any permission to use our copyrighted ebook material except to show and get customers for yourself. Okay? And yes, I am the only licensed LPN security processor in the United States, the USA, the Texas Republic Nation, and the world, for all I know. I am David Allen Young, the sovereign common law Texas Republic Nation Chief Justice Judge for Travis County and Austin. And I am a true lawyer. Lawyer, I said a lawyer, not an attorney. And a lawyer is one who is learned in the law, as stated in the United States Attorney General's Handbook. Do not confuse me with a private forum bar school attorney that only knows the bar and business courtroom procedures that you as 14th Amendment citizens are under. And I do not practice bar or United States corporation law in any business bar court. But as an impartial and justice-based common law Texas Republic Nation judge that is not under the color of law of the foreign United States corporation or the bar or the banks, I practice common law, and that is right and wrong law. When you decide to join us as a Texian in the Texas Republic Nation, just contact me and I'll get you sworn in as a Texian national with only 6 months of living in the Texas Republic Nation. We have no immigration laws, folks, so everyone is invited. Since our Texas Republic Nation has been legally and lawfully perfected, vested, salvaged, and revitalized out of dormancy in January 2017, with our declaration as a Our Declaration of Independence as a sovereign standalone world nation presented and mailed to the United Nations and the United States Secretary of State in March of 2017. If you are interested in any Texas Republic Nation government position in the county you live in, you must be a verified, sworn-in Texan, be law-abiding, and causing no harm or injury to your fellow Texians. We're also looking for peace officers, military and staff on Army, Texans to make a difference in our common law courts as jurists who decide and make the common law. We're looking for to start a grand jury, folks, in order to prosecute all these crooked attorney judges and attorneys in general that are breaking the law every day. All of you men and women of like mind are welcome to become a verified sworn in Texan, no matter which state of or country you now reside in, and enjoy your presently lost freedoms and rights in the Texas State Republic. In the Texas Republic Nation, which is an independent, sovereign world country bordering the countries of the United States Corporation and Mexico. And remember, folks, to discharge your debts one at a time, please go to the website above, and hopefully I'll see you there. Thank you very much. This is Judge David Allen Young, common law, and a lawyer under the United States Attorney General's Handbook, and not an attorney. And I do not practice law with or without a license in the United States or in the United States Bar Courts. Thank you very much, folks.